listening to Trusting God at All Times, a daily devotion of Peakland United Methodist Church. My name is Kim Ness, and I'm the office manager here at Peakland. One of the building blocks in a life of following Christ is to be a disciple and follow where he goes. Those first disciples followed Jesus. Where he went, they went. When he spoke, they listened. Where he performed miracles, they watched. When he boarded a boat, they followed. They got in the boat. One of the first stories I remember hearing when I started attending adult worship was the story of Jesus calming the sea. I shared this story when I taught Sunday school, and I helped teach the kindergarten class on occasion. And one Sunday, this was the scripture in the lesson. Picture it. Jesus, having spent hours upon hours performing miracles and telling parables and just walking around the towns, was tired. He wanted nothing more than to take a nap. He wanted to be away from people for a few moments and catch a few precious minutes of sleep. So, he boarded a boat and went to take a nap. Minutes after he has fallen asleep, a fierce storm comes over the sea. The boat is beaten by waves and torrents of rain. The wind is howling and the disciples are getting scared. Actually, they're not just scared. They were terrified. They started shouting. They rushed to the bed where Jesus was sleeping. They woke him up by shouting, "Jesus, help! We're going to be killed!" Jesus rubbed his eyes, got off the bed, put his feet on the floor, and stood up. He headed topside to this monstrous storm. He raised his hands and said, "Peace, be still." Suddenly, everything got quiet. Now, the Bible doesn't say that the fierce pouring rain became a drizzle, or that the waves that had been battering the boat to the point of capsizing calmed and gently rocked the boat. Nor does it say that the wind that churned up those massive waves that threatened to wash everyone overboard changed to a gentle breeze that rocked the boat like a baby cradle. It got quiet. The waves stopped rolling, the breeze quit blowing, the rain ceased. Everything stopped. It got quiet. Jesus looked to the disciples and said, "What is wrong with you guys? Where is your faith?" That sudden calmness, that silence, at that moment, the quiet was more frightening to those 12 disciples than that storm had ever been. In that quiet, they realized just how powerful Jesus was. It is written in Luke 8:25 that the disciples asked, "Who then is this, that he commands even the winds and the water, and they obey him?" These disciples were fishermen by trade. They knew boats. They knew the sea. They had faith to get on the boat with Jesus, but was that difficult for them? They were fishermen. Boats were safe havens for them. They rode in boats all the time. They sailed through many storms during their careers. What was different about this boat and this storm? The boat was their faith, and the storm was life. Faith is our boat, a boat that must be rocked, sometimes violently, to remind us of our faith, to help us understand who is in control of the rocking of the boat. The waves that hit us, the winds that howl against the sides, all of it is controlled by God. He's not making it difficult for us or causing these things to happen. He's giving us the faith and the tools to continue in the boat, to continue on the course, to navigate through our lives. Jesus knew that the boat was being hit by a massive storm, and he wasn't worried. Why? Because he knew who was in control. So what are you going to do when you're asked to follow Jesus? Get in the boat.